Namaskar everyone. In the previous videos, we discussed about the revaluation of asset and liabilities. There are two effects of recording the revaluation of asset and liabilities. First, when firm or partners want to record the revised value of the assets and liability, and when revised value are not to be recorded. So, in today's video, we'll take one example related to second effect, that when revised value are not to be recorded in the books of accounts. So in the coming slide, we'll take one example. So here is the example. This is the question number of 40 of chapter number 6, that is LMN are partners in the ratio of equal proportion. So the ratio of partners are 1:1:1. On 31st March, balance sheet is given in the question. So after the balance sheet, partner decided that with effect from 1st April, they will share the profit and loss in the ratio of 4:2:1. So 4:2:1 is the new ratio of the partners. And at the starting of the question, there is an old ratio, that is 1:1:1. So by old and new ratio, we can calculate sacrifice and gaining ratio, that we'll discuss later on. Next, for this purpose, goodwill is valued at 2-year purchase of average profit of last 4 years. So in this question, the method of calculating goodwill is average profit method that I already discussed at the beginning of this chapter. So 4 year profits are given. In the first year, there is a loss, and in remaining year there is a profit. Now after that, further agreed that provision for doubtful debt is increased by 2000, stock is appreciated by 20%, fixed asset is depreciated by 10%, and creditor be taken at 49,000. So all these 3 points is related to revaluation of asset and liability. This is the most important point. Now at the last, one information is given: partner do not desire to record the revised value of asset and liability in the books. So this is the most important point, that partners do not want to record the revised value. This is the second effect of revaluation of asset and liability. And they also desire to leave the reserves and surplus undistributed. So we'll consider, and it will be given in the question, that desired value is to be recorded or not to be recorded. But in this question, they do not want to record the revised value. So we'll do the question according to this particular line. So in the next slide, we'll discuss about the calculation part. So first of all, you have to calculate the profit and loss on revaluation. In this question, it is given that partners do not want to record revised value of asset and liability. So you have to prepare revaluation account. It is sure that you have to prepare revaluation account, but in a statement form. And after the profit and loss of revaluation, it will be distributed in sacrifice and gaining ratio. So let's move to the calculation part of revaluation profit and loss. There is two information out of the 3 points given in the last slide that result in profit on revaluation, that is increase in stock, that is 1,80,000 is increased by 20%. So 36,000, there is an increase in stock, and liability is decreased by 9,000. That is a difference of book value and market value. That is book value that is given in the balance sheet, and market value of creditor is given in the additional information. So the difference of these two is 9,000. So two items will result in increase in asset or decrease in liability, or we can say profit on revaluation. So total profit on revaluation is 45,000. But again, in the given 3 point, two transactions are result in loss on revaluation. That is provision for doubtful debt increased by 2000, and there is a decrease in fixed asset by 10%. So 2,20,000 and the 10% of 2,20,000 is 22,000. So the net profit on revaluation is 21,000. So this is how you have to calculate the profit on revaluation. In the next slide, we'll discuss about the journal entry of profit on revaluation. So before passing any journal entry, you have to calculate sacrifice and gaining ratio. As I already told you, in the given question, old ratio is 1 is to 1 is to 1. That is given in the question. And new ratio is also given 4 is to 2 is to 1. Now you have to put the formula of sacrifice ratio, that is old minus new ratio. If the answer come in positive, then it is sacrifice ratio, and in negative, it is a gaining ratio. So all the three partners are there, L, M, and N. Old ratio is 1 upon 3, 1 upon 3, and 1 upon 3. 3 is the total of ratio. And new ratio is 4 upon 7, 2 upon 7, and 1 upon 7. So the net effect is that L is gaining by 5 by 21, M and N is sacrificing by 1 by 21 and 4 by 21. And one more thing, that sacrifice is always equals to gain. So M and N is sacrificing, and the total of M and N is equals to L, that is called gaining partner. Now, second thing is you have to distribute revaluation profit. In the last slide, we calculate revaluation profit, and it came 21,000. So you have to distribute 21,000 in sacrifice and gaining ratio. That is 5 by 21, 1 by 21, and 4 by 21. So entry amount is 5,000, L is gaining, M and N is sacrificing 1,000 and 4,000. So first calculate sacrifice gaining ratio and distribute revaluation profit in sacrifice and gaining ratio. In the next slide, we discuss about how to pass the general entry. So you have to pass single general entry. Gaining partner will be debited and sacrificing partner capital account will be credited. So from the last slide, it is clearly evident that L is gaining and M and N is sacrificing. So entry will be L capital account debit to M capital account and to N capital account. And the amount of 5,000, 1,000 and 4,000 that we already calculated in the last slide. So in this example, I am only taking the calculation of revaluation account. So in nutshell, when it is given in the question that revised value are not to be recorded in the books of account, then first calculate the profit and loss on revaluation. Second, calculate sacrifice and gaining ratio. Third, distribute the profit and loss of revaluation in sacrifice and gaining ratio. And fourth one is pass adjustment entry, that is gaining partner capital account debit to sacrificing partner capital account. So this is all about the revised value of asset are not to be recorded in the books of account. Thank you so much.